or a section of town in Brandon here that doesn't have the roads in disrepair. Look at those holes there. 4 or 5 inches deep. And the town crews can't fill those holes. Here we are coming down Marble Street towards the police station. Look at the holes. Look at the torn up pavement. Look at, did you see the pastures? The opposite lane, how bad that was? My God. Where does our town money go to? Yeah. Here's Park Avenue, where we have the some of the highest home values in this town here, the village. Look at the road here. Look at the side of the road. The ditch area is all chewed up. All chewed up. Look at all this. It's just ladled like little miniature potholes. And nothing's been filled in here. I've lived in this town for 5 years now. Nothing's been taken care of. I complained to Richard Baker a couple months ago, and they actually filled the hole right in front of Hannaford's. Was about 6 to 8 inches deep. Hit it, you sunk into it. Look at this. This is a joke. This is the picturesque town of village of Brandon, Vermont. Let me show you a couple more roads. Coming downtown through the village. Not so bad here. An occasional bump here or there. With my injury, I try to hug the yellow line to avoid these bumps. Otherwise, the jarring motion kills my back. And I'm sure I'm not the only one that feels that way. Look at that truck and trailer in front of us. I don't know if the camera shows it. Just bouncing around. There's the bumps. They're both tire swipe areas. Just jars the hell out of your vehicle. Why would anybody want to move to Brandon with the roads in disrepair of that? That's the first telltale sign. Look at it. Look at the potholes. That's typical. Now I'm getting a close-up of it. This is Brandon, Vermont. Where's our taxpayer dollars going to? Look at the holes over there on that side of the street. Look at them. Look at them over this way. Gigantic puddle. Where nobody sticks to roads, so you have a gigantic mud puddle. I'll get that on the way back. We'll go out towards the town garage, where it goes from city roads, village roads, into the highway. Watch the transition. Only 100 feet or so right from the town garage. Gotta love this one. Look in the oncoming lane right there. All chewed up. Here we go. Get right before it turns into state highway. This part of this road right here has been chewed up like this for 15 years. Back when he used to drive truck. Look how chewed up this is. Do they fix this road? Do they give a care? Hell no. That's a town of Brandon. Oh, let me go down here and pull into the garage and turn around. Show how actually close we are to the town garage. So you can't tell me that the town highway department comes in and out here and they don't realize how bumpity the roads are. Municipal employees only. Okay, I'm going to go in there. I don't want to get charged with trespassing, but there you go. There's the town garage and town highway department, and that close to the town garage and roads are in that much of disrepair. Shameful, shameful. Again, right where the town roads start and the highway ends on 73. Look at the roads. Look how slow everybody's going because it's that damn bumpity. Gotta love the village of Brandon. Pay your taxes, come spend your dollars, We're not going to fix the roads. Like we'll go down Union Street. Look how chewed it up it is. Right there in about the center of the frame is the one they filled in about 2 months ago when I had to call Richard Baker here coming out of Hannaford's. Gigantic pothole to what it took out your front end of your vehicle. And as we progress down Union Street, this is typical of any street around the village of Brandon, Vermont. Look at that. And I'm done. I'm sick of it. It's appalling.